Good evening. In just a few hours, we will know the full details of a crucial federal budget that will impact every Australian battling through this cost of living crisis. It has now been revealed that the budget will include a back-to-back surplus, the first time that's been achieved in two decades. And there are some huge spends on tax cuts, housing and local manufacturing. What remains to be seen, though, is what the other cost of living relief will be announced as the government tries to walk that fine line between helping struggling Australians while not fueling inflation.
Not quite walking on water, but close enough. Jim Chalmers convinced he's found a delicate balance.
You know, I say to people who are doing it tough and to the most vulnerable people in our community that help is on the way in the budget.
He'll be the first Treasurer to deliver back-to-back surpluses since Peter Costello in 2007 and 8, forecasting $9.3 billion this financial year, following last year's surplus of $22.1 billion. It's largely driven by low unemployment, people working and paying tax.
So that's not an end in itself. It's not necessarily a cause for celebration.
Because it'll be short-lived, in the 3 years to come, deficits will be even bigger than first thought, the federal government blaming so-called unavoidable spending on defence, the NDIS and interest payments on debt.
We're seeing restraint from households. They've got no choice, but no restraint from this government and from this Treasurer.
The centrepiece of tonight's cost of living help, as flagged, Stage 3 tax cuts for every worker from July. There's also money to reduce student HECS debts, pay rises for aged care and childcare workers, adding superannuation to paid parental leave, opening more urgent care clinics and building new homes.
To take money off people that don't need it and give it to people that do.
The second priority is the Future Made in Australia program to lure private investment. $3 billion already announced in grants and subsidies for solar panels, quantum computing and critical minerals. Despite that cash splash...
This budget will be part of the solution when it comes to inflation, not part of the problem.
Forecasting inflation will be back under control by Christmas, a year earlier than the Reserve Bank's prediction.
Mortgage holders will measure the success of tonight's budget on whether it does ease inflation enough for the RBA to cut interest rates. There may or may not be another budget before Australians go to the polls.
This is going to be a Labor budget. Now, that's the worst possible outcome for the Australian people.
Tonight's budget will deliver for all Australians, not just some.
Putting pressure on the Treasurer to hand down an election-winning budget tonight.
Our pressure is a privilege.
Well, let's bring in our political reporter, Chloe Bouris, now, who is at Parliament House for us tonight. Chloe, you've got some fresh and new details about what's actually in this budget.
Yes, I can reveal that tonight's federal budget will include energy rebates for every Australian household. Last time around, it was only for low-income families. So this is a significant expansion, more than had been expected. How it will work, how much it will help families save on those energy bills, we don't yet know. I can also confirm that there will be an increase to Commonwealth rent assistance. Again, still very light on the details, but the federal government will claim that these two measures won't add to inflation. In fact, it'll claim that it will help reduce headline inflation by half a percentage point. How that'll work, we'll get more information in just a few hours when Treasurer Jim Chalmers hands down his third federal budget.
We will know soon enough. All right, Chloe, thank you. And in tonight's late news, we will, of course, have the full breakdown on the budget. That's at 10 p.m. on 10 Play and 10:30 on Channel 10.